You know, when I proclaimed martial law, I didn't proclaim martial law alone. It is made to appear as if I just signed a decree and said, I impose martial law on each and every one of you. No. I ask the legislature to please pass a law proclaiming martial law because there was anarchy in the country. Now, let me say this. The opposition was strong. And they were members of the Security Council, and somehow they had adopted a resolution which required that there be a unanimous vote for the armed forces to be able to move. And therefore, the armed forces was immobilized. At the same time, I asked the opposition party to come and join me in a coalition government. I offered one half of the cabinet. And of course, they laughed at me and said, why should we join you? We're going to take over the government. By the time you are through with the exercise, you're dead, politically and otherwise. So, and they refused to join me. I asked the advice of the judiciary. I asked the Supreme Court justices, the Court of Appeals justices, and the members of the private sector. And all of them told me there's only one man who can proclaim martial law, and that is the president. And you are it. You are the only one who can proclaim martial law. This is why I must carry this particular mark in our history. I could not have transferred it to the legislature. Why? Because the legislature did not have the power. What does the Constitution provide? The president shall be the commander-in-chief of the armed forces of the Philippines, and he may order the armed forces out to quell any disorder, riot, rebellion, invasion, insurrection, and in case of invasion, insurrection, rebellion, or imminent danger thereof, when the public safety requires it, he may suspend the privilege of the writ of habeas corpus or proclaim martial law throughout the Philippines or any part thereof. What does that provision provide? It provides that only the president can proclaim martial law. I repeat, that is why I had to assume our responsibility. And I am not one for shirking duty. The people said there was necessity for proclaiming martial law. And the people said, you are the only official who can proclaim martial law. So I proclaimed martial law. And I sincerely believed that it was necessary to proclaim martial law to install order and stability because there was complete anarchy throughout the country at the time.
Thank you for watching.